Hello friends, welcome back to RC with Popeye. I hope you're having fun and enjoying your life to the fullest. And with this message, let's start today's video. Today I'm going to do the complete review of FAYEE FY003. Essentially, this is a replica of Landrover Defender 90, and this is a 1/16 scale made by FAYEE. As you already know that there is a 1/12 scale MN90 model already available in the market. So what's different here? So here in this, you are getting a Wi-Fi module for FPV. Along with the tracks, you have wheels. In this video, I'll show you all the items in this RTR, all the recommended parts for this Defender 90 model, as well as a complete review where you will see it working with tracks, wheels, and the Wi-Fi FPV. The plastic of this hard body is quite impressive. It looks premium. Even though it's glossy, it has a kind of matte look on this. As you can see, they have also provided window panes with glasses, and it has got a similar C chassis like WPL and MN models. Apart from this, you'll get this transmitter. We'll check this whether this is fully proportional or not. You get this set of wheels. They have also given a set of decals where the incorrect spelling is quite visible. It's better for you to scan these decals, do some correction, and make your own decals. And a Wi-Fi camera for FPV, and this is one mobile holder. Here it is, Wi-Fi camera, mobile holder. And all of this costs around $60. This is a very good looking Defender 90 model, and in all sense, this will be a toy grade RC car until you upgrade this. 6 volts nickel cadmium battery. I'll put this in charge. A small Phillips screwdriver, and there's generic USB charger. It has 2 working headlights. The side lights are not illuminated with LEDs though. It has nice adjustable mirrors. The details inside the dashboard, I hope this is visible to you. The details inside the dashboard is also quite good. So talking about the wheels, this has nice gray silver metallic rims, white tires compared to WPL tires. As you can see, the height as well as width is more. The softness of these tires are as close as WPL kit tires. Not as soft as WPL, but very close to the WPL kit tires. So I have aligned MN, FAYEE and WPL together. As you already know that this is a 1/12 scale model as mentioned by MN models. This one is 1/16 and these two are 1/16 models. But going by the looks, this WPL seems too small when you compare it with these two models. Even though both of them are Defender 90 replica, both of them look very different. This one MN model looks quite boxy with more width and lesser length, while this FAYEE model has lesser width and more length, giving this a more boxy look and giving this a more modern look. So let's test out the remote of this. As you can see, the steering is not fully proportional. So it has 2-3 stages of turning in between. Let's check out the throttle. So the throttle seems to be fully proportional. So definitely, this has to be upgraded if you want a hobby kind of performance. So now let's quickly check out what kind of motor, drivetrain and axles this has. This is a 180 motor inside this gearbox, and to make it better, you can upgrade it with WPL gearbox, either a dual speed or a metal transmission. I have given all the links of the upgrades and this RC car in the description. Do check out if you want to purchase this. Now let's check out what kind of axle they have provided. So as you can see, the gears are made of plastic. They are given a nice setup to hold mobile. So in order to make this FPV work, we need to install one app called iSpy Car. You can download this from Google Play or iOS App Store. So to connect to the camera Wi-Fi, you just need to connect this one. It's now connected. So let's go to the app. So now, as you can see, the camera is working. As you can see, the resolution shows here is 480p. If you want to control this RC car with Wi-Fi controller, then you need to switch off this transmitter. Then you can choose the settings. First option is single handle. Now check this out. Check the steering and as well as the remote. Remote is quite sensitive. Now check the different setting right now. We have dual handle. Now let's choose this track settings. This is actually a very nice feature. You can give the path to it. Now I have set to gyroscopic mode. Let's see how it works. Check out how this works with FPV, without FPV, with tires and with tracks in broad daylight. Watch the video till the end and don't forget to subscribe to our channel.
The 180 motor seems fine. It actually works very good. It's able to climb steep places. Thank you. As you can see, the tracks are actually slipping a lot. See, if I hold it, it will still move. Basically, the problem is with this loose fitted belt for the tracks.
So this is the camera quality. As you can see, this is 480p. This is like, just it will be helpful to see the track, otherwise the video quality is poor. But still, it's fun. It's an FPV.